गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द केमिस्ट्री के चैनल। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस आयनिक कंपाउंड, देयर फॉर्मेशन, आयनिक बॉन्ड एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर, आयन्स प्रोडक्शन बिटवीन द एटम्स इन एन आयनिक कंपाउंड। लेट्स बिगिन विद आयनिक कंपाउंड्स डेफिनेशन। द बॉन्ड फॉर्म्ड बाय द ट्रांसफर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम एन इलेक्ट्रोपॉजिटिव एटम टू अनदर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एटम is called ionic bond, and the resulting compounds are known as ionic compounds. Ionic compounds are made up of ions, the positive and the negative ions. So let's see ions production, how ions are produced in ionic compounds. The element of the group first and second are electropositive metals, and they have ability to lose electrons to complete their octet. So they tend to lose electron. They have 1 to 2 electrons in their outermost shell, so they easily lose their electrons to gain stability, to complete their octet, to gain the nearest noble gas electronic configuration. They form positive ions. For example, sodium has 1 electron in its valence shell. It tend to lose this 1 electron and form the sodium ion. On the other hand, magnesium has 2 electrons in its valence shell. It loses these 2 electrons to form magnesium ion. On the other hand, the elements of the group 15 and to 17 are electronegative nonmetals, and they have ability to gain electrons to complete their octet. So they tend to lose their electrons. They have 5, 6 and 7 valence electrons in their outermost shell, so they tend to gain electrons to complete their octet, to gain stability, to gain the nearest noble gas configuration. They form negative ions. For example, chlorine gain an electron to form chloride ion. Fluorine gain 1 electron to form fluoride ion. Formation of the bond. The positive and the negative ions produced are combined by the electrostatic force of attraction to each other, forming the ionic compound. The ions produced by gaining and by losing electrons, they now attract each other by the electrostatic force of attraction to form a bond, which is known as ionic bond, to gain stability, to attach with themselves. In this process, energy is released. In this process, energy is released. When the positive and the negative ions come close to each other, energy is released. Let's see an example. NaCl, sodium ion plus chloride ion, come close to each other and form NaCl. They are held with each other by the electrostatic force of attraction, which is the force between the positive and the negative ions. Overall reaction is 2Na, two molecules, two atoms of sodium and a chlorine gas molecule. They react to form two formula units of the sodium chloride. For KCl, potassium chloride, two potassium atoms react with the chlorine gas and form two potassium chloride salt. Let's see the properties of ionic compounds. What are the properties of ionic compounds? Properties of ionic compounds. The compounds formed by the combination of positive and negative ions are known as ionic compounds. They are formed by the combination of positive and negative ions. For example, sodium ion and chloride ion. They have high melting and boiling point. Due to the strong force of attraction called the electrostatic force of attraction, they all have high melting and boiling points. They are strongly held to each other. They have strong electrostatic force of attraction between the ions. That's why they have high melting and boiling points. They are soluble in water due to the polarity of water and insoluble in the organic solvents. They are soluble in water because water has two poles, hydrogen partial positive and oxygen partial negative. That's why they all are soluble in water. Mostly are soluble in water, but some are insoluble in water. So they are mostly soluble in water. Crystalline solids, they are crystalline solids and non-conductor in solid form, and conduct electrons or electricity in molten or solution forms. Brittle in nature due to the repulsion between the layers when displaced. When the layers of the ionic compounds are displaced, the ions come opposite to each other. The same ions come opposite to each other and they repel each other and they start to brittle. That's why they are brittle in nature. When pressure is applied to them, they dislocate from their position and the crystal is broken down. That's all, friends. Let's meet you in the next lecture. Allah Hafiz for now.